Today, I want to tell you about an API we are developing that we are actually making publicly available for you to use. This API allows you to convert your Facebook exported data from JSON format to an Excel spreadsheet. For example, if you want to analyze or to have some reporting in Power BI reporting services, or any other reporting system that you may use, Tableau, for example, you could use a spreadsheet and add more information there easily. It's way more easy to modify an Excel spreadsheet than modifying a JSON file for reporting purposes. So, when you have exported your Facebook data from Facebook, you will have a zip file with the name Facebook on Facebook dash and your username. Once you have unzipped that file, you will have a structure similar to this one, depending on when you and what you chose to export. What we are supporting currently is converting your post file, which are prefixed with your underscore posts. So you take those files and you use our API. The API will process the file and it will generate a spreadsheet with some of the content found there. How you do that? So you can go to the Rapid API page. You can look for our APIs. You will see that in here we have this Facebook data converter. And you will see that we have here this endpoint. I already have it here. It's almost the same. And you will need to set the actual file URL. That file needs to be in a publicly available URL, and it must be one of the your posts.json files. Okay, then you'll set the actual email where you want to send it. You set the 1.0 version, because that's the only version we are supporting at the moment for APIs. But however, the more changes we do, if there are breaking changes, we are going to try to not break the existing versions of the APIs, but instead creating new versions for those endpoints so it doesn't affect the existing applications. And this flag generates only items recommended for text analysis. It basically tells the API if you want to have in the Excel even those text, the rows with text where the text is not long enough for running text analytics. Because these APIs are actually designed, especially designed to be used with our other APIs, which allows you to analyze your spreadsheet and get sentiment information, the key phrases and all that. But if you don't need it for those purposes, you can just choose false. Then you hit test endpoint. It will run a test. And at the same time, it will send the actual results to your email. So you see that here we have a response of 200 success. Since we are returning an octet stream, we are this UI doesn't support it or not for that. So we get that this property must be a valid JSON object. But in the headers, you will see that you have a content disposition, which is an attachment. The file name is results.xlsx. The content type is this spreadsheet in OpenXML format. And let's see if I already receive the email notification. No, let's open my email. And you should see that here we have this Facebook converted file, which I get it at 5:25 a.m., which is pretty much this time of the day. And I can open that in Excel, and you will get something like this. You will get a spreadsheet with the record unique ID, with the record date, with the sentiment analysis placeholder, which is just an empty column at the moment. And that will be filled if you continue running our analysis with the other endpoints. The post text, the place sentiment, which basically the purpose of this is that you can actually, with our other APIs, you get the sentiment. This is actually wrong at the moment. That's a bug. There should be the place sentiment should be an empty column, and this is actually the place the names are not okay at the moment, so we need to fix that. But yeah, you will have the actual record unique ID, an empty column for the place sentiment, the actual place name, the latitude and the longitude, and the address that was found, along with a URL for the place. So if you continue running our process with the endpoints, like you convert your JSON to Excel spreadsheet, and then you get that spreadsheet, or you send it either that spreadsheet or any other spreadsheet with the same formatting columns, you will get as a response and the same spreadsheet modified with the actual results for the sentiment, with the key phrases that are being used the most in your text, some charts about the behavior, the values, the openness, your personality, basically based on what was found, based on the text that was analyzed, along with this other sheet with this basically to allow you to detect the sentiment that was found at a specific place. So you could do something like a match of, okay, I had a sentiment of 0.3, so that's a very negative sentiment at this place on this date, or at least that text was published or was found at that date and was linked with this specific place. So you can create some links on data there to create some further analysis and get more insights about the reasons why that sentiment was low or high, depending on how it was. Those other endpoints to analyze that text, they are already published in some of other APIs. We are going to make them available in Rapid API soon. But yeah, this is one of the first stages, and this allows you also to use the spreadsheet for any other purposes that you may want. As I was saying, they are very useful to create some Power BI reports, Tableau reports, reporting services reports, or any other kind of application that you may seem fit for them. Please let us know any other information that you may consider useful to have in the output spreadsheet. So we will take consideration your feedback and apply whatever we consider best in there. Thank you very much and have a good day.